Hey y'all, how y'all doing today? My name is Supernatural Kelly, and I'm back with an inspirational word from God. So today, the Holy Spirit has sent me with another word. I am actually reporting from my tiny home, right in my backyard. Tiny home, tiny salon, she shed, whatever you want to call it. But the Holy Spirit led me back here. I've been coming back here. I meditate out here, and I was like, oh, the Holy Spirit was like, why not do your video out here today? Why not? Okay. So today we are going to be talking about itching ears. Okay. Itchy ears. So let's go ahead and pray and welcome the Holy Spirit into this atmosphere and allow him to take over this atmosphere. Thank you, Father God, for blessing us with yet another day to gather in your presence, dear Lord. Thank you, Father God, for leading me into this word. Holy Spirit, speak through me, none of me and all of you. Let your people hear exactly what you want them to hear about this word today, Father God. May their ears be anointed to hear this word and their hearts blessed to receive. I ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so today I have scripture. I'm going to be coming out of 2 Timothy 4, 2 through 5. Okay? It says, preach the word, be ready in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, and exhort with complete patience and teaching. For the time is coming, when people will not endure sound teaching, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own passion. And will turn away from listening to the truth and wander off into myths. As for you, always be sober-minded, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, and fulfill your ministry. Okay, so I hope y'all can hear me well. I hear the train going by. The train is not even really close by my house, but it's like you can hear it all the way from wherever it is. But yes, the Holy Spirit is saying, in these last times, there will be people having itching ears, okay? They are going to be trying to find inspiration in all the wrong places, okay? Instead of coming into the word of God, okay? Which is the true word, in Jesus' name. Let's go ahead and break down the scripture a little bit, okay? He's saying, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is the judge, who is to judge the living and the dead, okay? And when you say living and dead, it's meaning, you know, the people that is alive and awake and their eyes is open into the word of God. And then we have the people that is actually spiritually dead, walking around in the world, don't know whether if they coming or going, okay? So that is the spiritually dead, okay? And by his appearing and his kingdom. He wants us to preach the word, okay? Go out and preach this word to the four corners of the earth, okay? To everyone that will hear it, in Jesus' name. With complete patience and teaching, okay? He don't want us to get impatient with people, you know, the spiritually awakened and the spiritually dead. We need to have patience. And we know that patience is a virtue, okay? Being kind and not getting angry while you're waiting, okay? For those people to come into the word, okay? We all have a responsibility in the kingdom, and it is to preach the word and to bring people in. Okay? For the time is coming where people will not endure sound teaching, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own passions. So again, people is not going to want to hear the word of God. They are going to want to hear anything or anyone that's agreeing with what they says. And we know that birds of a feather flock together. You always going to find someone that's going to agree with what you're saying. It's always going to be someone to join your pity party. But the word here is saying that we are not supposed to have itchy ears. We are supposed to go to the word, listen to those people that are preaching the truth, the true gospel of Christ, and learn from that. Okay? And it's saying that those people, again, will turn away from listening to the truth and wander off into myths. So they are not going to want to hear what you're saying. They're not going to want to hear the truth, but they're going to wander off into myths and old wives' tales and stuff that is not coming from the word of God. And it's saying that we must stay away from those, because myths is not true. The only thing that is true is this living word of God. And it's saying, as for you, always be sober-minded, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, and fulfill the ministry. Okay, what is an evangelist? An evangelist is someone that try to bring people into the kingdom of God, try to convert people from darkness to light. I've been an evangelist since I was little. I always knew that was my calling. The Holy Spirit always spoke to me, and I just thank God that the Holy Spirit led me into wanting to teach the word of God to his people, in Jesus' name. So that's pretty much all that I have to say today about this word. But again, I pray that you all can get into a Bible-based church. If you're not a person that goes to church, then it's so much on social media, whether it be Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all of these different avenues where you can find the word of God. But then there is a lot of myths and other stuff that, you know, will tickle your ears. But we're not looking for those words, in Jesus' name. We are looking for the true word of God, okay, so that we can continue to build the kingdom of God right here on earth, okay? Because one day, God is going to wipe this place out, and he's going to create a new earth, and he's going to create this new earth with people that believe in him, people that have been following his word, and everyone else is going to be thrown into the lake of fire. Okay? The earth has been going through a lot lately, and God is pretty much fed up and ready for a new thing. He's ready to do a new thing. So trust him, believe, rebuke, teach those that want to learn, and whatever is for you, is for you. Test the word. Test the word of God to make sure that a word is for you. Okay? Teach in season and out of season. If it's for you, it's for you. If it's not, it's not. This video may not be for you in this season. Maybe it will be for you in another season, in Jesus' name. But we are supposed to be kind to each other about whatever it is that the Holy Spirit is leading. Okay? If you have not received the Lord, Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, I want to give you a chance to accept Him right now, today, okay? With this simple prayer. Repeat after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that You are our Savior, Father God. I realize that You are the Savior, in Jesus' name. I confess with my mouth that You are Lord. I believe that You died and God raised You up on the third day. I receive You in my heart and I accept You as my Lord and personal Savior. Okay? If you repeated that simple prayer with me, welcome to the kingdom of heaven. Welcome to the kingdom of life. Welcome to the kingdom of God. Okay? If you like this video, go ahead, share it, get into a Bible-based church, listen to more of my videos, like this video so that it can get into the algorithm and you can hear more videos just like this one, okay, to teach you and get you prepared in this kingdom and so that you can find out what God has for you and what He wants you to do in Jesus' name. Now, I love y'all and I pray that you have a blessed day.